Hello, I'm Mark Sito. Welcome to this performance by the Brown University Orchestra. Of course, we had to do things a little bit differently this year. We focused on string orchestra repertoire and divided into two groups so that we could keep our gatherings small. But nonetheless, it was a real joy for us to be able to make music together and for us to have the opportunity to share our work with you now. The first work that you'll hear is Lyric for Strings by George Walker. Walker wrote this piece at the beginning of a long and illustrious career. He would eventually go on to become the first Black composer to win the Pulitzer Prize in Music. This early work was written in memory of Walker's late grandmother, Melvina King. And although it's a work that's born out of loss, it's ultimately uplifting and hopeful. We hope you enjoy. Our next selection is Strum by Jesse Montgomery. This piece has a connection to our city of Providence, in fact. Montgomery wrote the first version of Strum for the Providence String Quartet when she was a musician with Community Music Works right across town. It's an exuberant celebration of American folk idioms, and it's been a lot of fun to work on. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you. The next piece you'll hear is Entr'acte by Carolyn Shaw, another Pulitzer Prize recipient. Shaw describes this piece as a minuet and trio, which is a reference to the stylized dance forms that you find in the string quartets or symphonies of classical composers like Haydn or Mozart. In its essence, it's an ABA structure where you get an opening section, a contrasting middle, and then a reprise of the opening material. But Shaw leans into this idea of going for maximal contrast between these sections. She describes it as a sort of looking glass effect as we move from the A to the B section. And before we go back to the second A, she dives even further down the looking glass, if you will, into material that's even more removed from where we began. The way that she delineates these changes from A to B to C, if you will, to A again, is through a number of unusual string techniques. So to explain, I'll let a couple of our students demonstrate.
Hi, I'm Jade, and I'm a first-year violinist playing in the Brown University Orchestra. I'm planning on concentrating in neuroscience and music.
Hi, I'm Isaac, a violinist in the class of 2023.
I'm going to be demonstrating a couple of plucked or pizzicato techniques that Shaw uses to mark the different sections within the piece. There's regular pizzicato in the trio, and it sounds like this. There's also snap pizzicato, which marks the beginning of the trio, and this is where the string rebounds off of the fingerboard for a more percussive sound. There's also lute pizzicato, where things start to get a little weird. This is where you pluck with your left hand while the bow is staying on the string.
There are also a few interesting bow techniques. Some are pretty common, like the artificial harmonic, which allows string instruments to play any pitch as a harmonic. Shaw also asked the musician to draw their bow across the string without making any pitch as such. There are also a few other surprises in the piece, but we won't give everything away. We hope you enjoy Caroline Shaw's Entr'acte.
Thank you.
Thank you to Alex Ding for the wonderful cello solo at the end of the Shaw. Next up, we have two selections from the Novelettin for String Orchestra by Samuel Coleridge Taylor. These are delightful little character pieces that draw inspiration from dance idioms as well. And in fact, the second one that you'll hear is a piece that Coleridge Taylor titles a waltz. And that one features the wonderful Sarah Kim on violin. Since we're at the end of an academic year, we wanted to take a minute to celebrate our graduating students from the class of 2021. They've actually been at Brown longer than I have, and they've been a wonderful cohort who have really helped to steer the orchestra through a period of transition and showed me the ropes when I arrived here. They've been absolutely fantastic to work with, and I'll turn things over to them to introduce themselves.
Hi, my name is Ellie. I play viola, and I concentrate in computer science. I think my favorite piece that I've played with the Brown Orchestra is Brahms 1, which we played my freshman fall. And then, let's see, outside of orchestra, I've really enjoyed taking a wide variety of classes. So stuff like medical illustrations, Ghanaian drumming, history, environmental science, just because Brown has so much to offer.
I'm Mallory. I am a violinist in the Brown Orchestra for 4 of the last 6 years, finishing a PhD in anthropology. Favorite piece. Probably the two favorite pieces during my time here were Scheherazade from last year, and then when we played Stravinsky's Firebird, which I think was 5 or 6 years ago.
Hi, I'm Rainbow. I am an upright bassist, and I am concentrating in education and history. I am a senior graduating in May, and I was the proud orchestra president last year. Woo. And my fondest memories are probably rallying people to go to orchestra setups for concerts, and I really enjoyed playing the St. John's organ piece and Mahler 1.
Hi, I'm Albert. I play the violin. I'm concentrating in applied math and econ. And probably my favorite piece was Tchaikovsky's Romeo and Juliet Overture. Yeah. I do really enjoy the time I had at orchestra, and I will miss it very much.
We love the BUO!
Congratulations again to Ellie, Mallory, Rainbow, and Albert. And I'd like to give a special thank you to Rainbow, who served as the president of the Brown University Orchestra in 2019 and 2020. Her leadership that year was absolutely indispensable, and for her work on behalf of the Brown University Orchestra, she is the 2021 recipient of the Brown Music Department's Rostropovich Prize in Music. Thank you and congratulations, Rainbow. We'd also like to thank everybody who made our work this semester possible, from our wonderful department staff, especially Jen, Drew, and Lauren, to the students who worked on this footage that you're seeing, Zoe and Pinya, to Brown Media Services and Brown Media Productions, and of course, all the students who performed in these ensembles this semester. We can't wait to make music for you again in the fall, hopefully under more welcoming circumstances. We'll be releasing a couple more videos over the coming weeks, so please stay tuned for that. But for this program, we have one more selection, and I'll turn things over to our bass player, Seth, to introduce it.
Hello. I'm Seth. I'm a sophomore right now studying engineering, and I'm a bassist in one of the orchestras this year. The final selection on this program is the first movement of Tchaikovsky's Serenade for Strings. This is personally one of my favorite pieces, so I was very pleased to be able to work on it throughout the semester, and it's also actually one of Tchaikovsky's works that he was most proud of. The first movement was written as an imitation of Mozart style, so it's generally just a very beautiful melodic piece, which is a lot of fun to play. And I think it's fair to say that the orchestra as a whole definitely enjoyed working on it throughout the semester. So, with that, here's the first movement of Tchaikovsky's Serenade for Strings.
Thank you. Thank you.